sorry.
He's like, what are you doing?
So by now, many of you have probably already seen the movie Black Panther and heard the song that was featured in it, All the Stars. I was challenged to recreate that song using nothing but sounds from a car. So everything you hear in this track was recreated from my friend's Honda Ridgeline. I'll show you how I did it. The first thing I did was I dragged all my sounds into SliceX NFL Studio, and I went through and listened to the sounds that I liked. Doors closing, windshield wipers. I then dragged in the original track for reference and then began to program the beat. Next, I have to recreate that boop sound, and the closest sound that I have for that would be the seatbelt warning sound. So I drag that sound into Harmer, and then I search for the pitch of that boop sound. Once I find the pitch, I program that in. As to how it's coming along, and it's sounding pretty good. Next, I need to create the bass, and the best sound for that would be the seat adjustment switch. It's really quiet, so I need to boost the volume. I drag that into Harmer and then convert it to an image, and then I cut out the messy frequencies. I then paste it back into Harmer. And it's sounding pretty good. That's the magic of additive synthesis. Additive, I can't even say it. Anyway, I click in the bass line, and I think that sounded pretty good. Car horn would do just the trick. I put that in Harmer. And then I throw in some reverb and a plugin called Effector, which modifies the sound in many different ways. I then play in the line. Now, using Effector, I automate the low pass filter. I do a rough guess in the beginning, and then I go in and program it more meticulously. I then move on to creating a pad. So I duplicate the horn sound, and I find a region that I can loop so that this horn would sustain. All right, now I just record a sustained drum. Now I throw in several effects, some delay, some reverb, and in order to create that warble effect, I throw on a plugin called Panomatic, which basically pans the sound left to right. All right, now I'm going to create another pad sound, so I duplicate that horn, and then I just throw in a ton of effects. I throw in some delay, a phaser, compression, and some EQ. And then I tweak each of these plugins to get the sound that I'm looking for. I think that sounded pretty good. So now what I'm going to do is I'm going to play that pad into the mix here. I'm going to do a comparison with the original, and it's sounding pretty close. I remember that there's a hi-hat sound later on in the track, and the closest sound that I have for that would be the turn signal, so I programmed that in. Great. So now I do another listen, and then I compare it to the original. Is it anything you everything you offer? I do the full heart. I think it sounded pretty good. So now I just gotta do some mixing and some further processing, and then get a couple friends to sing. There you have it. I was able to recreate this song using nothing but the sounds from a Honda Ridgeline. If you like that, be sure to like and subscribe, and leave suggestions down below of other songs you would like me to cover. All right, that's all I got.